Your Excellency Minister Diane Gashumba, my sister, and Dr. Gitanji Gitahi, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for the invitation to speak to you today, and I'm really sorry I can't be with you in person in Kigali. But first of all, I should greet you in Kenya, Rwanda, Amakuru, Muraho. As the son of Africa, I'm proud to see the progress the continent is making economically and politically, as well as in the health of its people. Between 2000 and 2015, life expectancy in Africa increased by almost 10 years, double the global average. But many challenges remain. As Africa becomes more prosperous, inequalities are growing. Some people can access world-class healthcare, while millions of others miss out on the most basic services. The best way to ensure everyone can access the health services they need without facing financial hardship is universal health coverage. And the foundation of universal health coverage is strong primary health care, with a focus on promoting health and preventing disease. This is not a job for the health sector alone. All countries must take a whole-of-government approach to address the economic, social, and environmental causes of ill health. In September, world leaders will meet at the United Nations General Assembly for the high-level meeting on universal health coverage. This is a key moment for catalyzing political support for our global movement. I look forward to a day when all the sons and daughters of Africa and all people everywhere get the health care they need, the health care they deserve. And I would like to use this opportunity to thank His Excellency President Paul Kagame for his leadership in improving the health of the continent. The last AU summit was an important example of his leadership. So I say thank you, and I say Murakoze Chane. Thank you.